la filosofía propia de nosotros. Pensar, hablar y hacer amanecer la palabra.
We think, we speak, and we make the word dawn, he said. The three pillars that hold a community of people together in the depths of the jungle. In our society, we say actions speak louder than words. And although this may be true in effect, we've fallen into the dangerous trap of putting empty actions on a higher pedestal than that of spoken word or wise thought. We have for too long focused on the vacuous movements of the fishtail and not on the head that creates them. We have become disconnected from our true nature within and without, because our thoughts, words, and actions are disconnected. But he reminded us that there is no action that is not preceded by a word, that there is no word that is not preceded by a thought. Because every action is born of pregnant intent. Every action begins first and foremost with the inception of an idea, a will. So, you may be asking, who is this man? And what is the idea that has spawned these words that you now hear? The story begins over a century ago with a young barefoot boy in the Amazon rainforest, far from what we call the Western world. The boy was part of a proud tribe, a tribe that called themselves the People of the Center, or Bora. In the midst of the whispering trees, he learned to listen to the roaring of the clouds, to watch the cascading of the rain and play in the rich banks of the river that guided the same water back to the ocean. He learned the connection of all things. Sometimes, his father would take him to their thatched spiritual home called Amaloka. There, with blue feathered crowns and green powdered lips, he watched the elderly shamans create a microcosm of wisdom. He saw them give their bodies as instruments for the spirits of tobacco and coca to express their word of truth. He heard their sacred word and he honored it so that his community could live in harmony with nature. But one fateful day, a white man from Europe, trembling in greed, arrived at the doorstep of their maloka with a cocked whip in one hand and white gold in the other, screaming, "Gauchuk! Gauchuk!" Gauchuk was what the Bora people called rubber, the white gold that they were after. What the boy then witnessed was nothing short of upheaval. Men, women, and children dispersed running for their lives. Those that got caught were chained and put in line, and those that got out of line were thrown into the maloka and turned to ashes. For decades, this calamity continued. The boy watched thousands upon thousands of his people become scattered dust in the wind. And with those fallen ones, their legacies, their memories, their unique tapestry sewn with Bora song and dance was lost. Only a handful of voices remained, including that of the boy who carried this message to you. Following this grave genocide, the boy was now a young man, a shamanic leader with sons of his own, now faced with picking up the pieces of his people's identity. And although they were physically crippled, their spirit remained standing. They remained the victorious survivors that would battle to keep their values and their culture alive. Many rotations around the sun he did pass, and he grew to be a wise elder of his clan. And although he knew that time is the agent of change, he did not see any. He would continue to hear the cries of his fellow native peoples. He would hear the ongoing sounds of infectious and rapacious greed that still carries on till this very day. Only now for a black gold and another kind of white gold. He would see his fellow native people still being enslaved, displaced, and massacred where chains were rejected, in order to strip their land naked and rape it for a dime. And so one day an idea was born. An idea that he channeled through the spirits of the plants. The idea was to build a spiritual home, a maloka, the same place where his family and friends were burned alive. Only now they were to build it with the help of Europeans. The plants told him this would be the only way to heal this open wound. And in traditional Bora principle, he sat with his sons and spoke the word of this intent. Now, years later after his death, his son delivered this word to us, a small group of European travelers that are volunteering for an international institution whose mission is to protect, to preserve, and to teach the ancient knowledge of this great planet. This institution is called the University of Ancient Wisdom, La Universidad de Sabiduría Ancestral. And we want to manifest this maloka into a reality. This spiritual home will be called the Maloka of Ancient Wisdom, a place where the world can learn how the resilient tribes of the Amazon heal and connect to their true nature through our Mother Nature. Not as her owner, but as her guardian. And in order to keep with our mission, our first teaching will come to you in the form of a documentary, as we will film the entire spiritual journey of building this roof of shamanic knowledge to share their viaje del alma, their journey of the soul. So, if you want to stand for the awareness of this grave genocide and for the pernicious ethnocides of today, if you want to stand against the further abuse of Amazonian rainforests, and most importantly, if you want to be a part of creating a space that will stand for the preservation of native culture and philosophy, donate now, and you can be a part of the final act of manifesting this idea. You can shed your light in the dawning of the word, the Maloka of Ancient Wisdom.